Hey guys, hopefully we're streaming live. Just give me one second. Right. So I think we are live and we can start our lecture. So today's topic, it's a very interesting one. It's a very interesting one, and it's often something where a lot of people have a little bit of doubts and confusions. So the topic for today's class, the topic for today's lecture, in fact, is embryology of the heart. Okay. Now, understand before we begin that there are two components to this lecture. There are two components to this lecture. And before I start with that, I want to welcome you to our YouTube channel, Let's Crack Neet PG, where you have the top educators, quality content, and you guys are assured a great learning experience. My name is Chaitanya Mittal. I'm pursuing my MBBS from AIIMS, New Delhi. And what I wanted to tell you guys about was, before I tell you about the Unacademy program, there is something I want to discuss with you guys. And as you guys might have appreciated, that I've changed the theme for today a little. I've done two changes. One, I have, because it's a lecture on heart, obviously, I've made the borders red. And that's something that I did. Second thing that I've done is I've used black screens to explain a little. So we have shifted to the dark mode for my lectures because I feel that sometimes you guys understand better with it. Okay. So the embryology of the CVS, you can grossly divide it into two things. You can divide it into two parts, right? CVS embryology, you can understand it in two different headings. One, the embryology of the heart. Second is the embryology of the vessels or the vasculogenesis, right? This may you study about the venous system and the arterial system, okay? And this may you talk about the aortic arches, what develops from which aortic arch, how which vein develop forms which structure, right? But I'm not going into those details because that is not the purpose of my lecture. My purpose of the lecture is focused on the part related to the heart, okay? So that is one thing that I want you guys to know. Now, before I begin, I want to tell you a little bit about the Unacademy Learning Program. I hope you guys have downloaded the app. Just go to the Play Store, download the Unacademy Learning app, and you guys can begin your learning. What you have to do is register with your mobile number, and then you guys have to use my invite code Chaitanya10, and you guys can unlock a free plan. We have a limited time offer exclusively for our students, and if you guys are interested in taking the Iconic subscription, where you are going to get both Unacademy and PrepLadder. So you are getting access to two apps, and for 3 years you will get it for 60,000. In fact, less than 60,000. For 2 years you are going to get it for 50,000, and for 1 year you are going to get it for 40,000. So my referral code is Chaitanya10. Please remember that you have to use this referral code while taking this offer. Okay, and don't use any other referral code because if anything goes wrong with any other referral code, I won't be able to help you out. But if you're using my referral code, I can assure you that you will get both your Unacademy as well as PrepLadder login details as soon as you take the subscription. Similarly, we have two subscriptions here. One is the Plus and one is the Iconic. So the Plus subscription has a 3 plus 1 and a 12 plus 2 offer going on. And again, please remember to use my referral code Chaitanya10. Don't go for any other random referral codes. Always use an authentic referral code. Okay. Okay, because these offers, they're limited time and they're available on select referral codes. Now, you have a Neet PG subscription, you have an FMGE subscription, right? You have a Next subscription, and you have an INICET. All of these courses, all of these batches are included in one single subscription, that is the Unacademy subscription. Even if you're preparing for your university exams, let's say first prof, and next year when you move to second prof, or even to your third prof, we are going to have batches ready for you guys. Okay, so we have first prof, second prof, third prof batches. And we have over 34,000 MCQs for you guys to attempt. So you guys can see what are the various pricing of the various plans and how much you need to pay for each. Obviously, if you take a larger plan, you are going to be having a more economic cost. So you can see that's all. There's almost a 3 times advantage of taking a 3-year course. Okay. So, and for the Plus subscription, you are going to get the live classroom experience with batch courses, weekly test, special tests, doubt clearing, etc. Right? In the Iconic subscription, what is extra? The video lectures and the question bank of PrepLadder, as well as the handwritten notes. Okay. So I would say go for the 3-year Iconic subscription. That's going to be the most beneficial for you. So let's begin with the embryology of the heart. Can we? Wait, let me just reset this a little. So that you guys can about what I write. I think that is fine. Are you guys able to see my screens properly? And you guys can hear me properly? Can we begin with embryology of the heart? Just give me one second, I'll also wear my mic. Okay, so give me a thumbs up or hit. Ready for this lecture? Hit the like button. Okay. Yes, you guys are. So let's begin with the embryology of the CVS or the embryology of the heart. Okay, so like I told you, embryology of the CVS in itself, it's a totally different topic. In itself, it's a totally different topic. The reason is that you are going to study the vessels also. You're going to study other things also in that. There are other parts to it. Okay, there are other parts to understanding the complete embryology of the CVS. So we're going to begin with the heart, and then the other part is relatively simple. The heart is obviously the more, so to speak, difficult topic. Okay, the embryology of the heart is the more generally considered to be the more difficult topic. Okay, so let's begin with embryology of the heart. Okay, so first thing that you have to understand is when the heart develops, it develops from a few cells and they are known to form the heart field. They are known to form the heart field. So heart field is nothing but a collection of cells which become specialized to develop into the heart. They are nothing but a collection of cells which specialize to develop as the organ that you know as heart, which specialize to develop the organ that you know as heart. Now there are two heart fields that are there. One is called as the primary heart field, the other is called as the secondary heart field. Primary heart field and secondary heart field. Now what is this concept of primary and secondary heart field? What is this concept of primary and secondary heart field? So first you have to understand ki jo heart hota hai na, it develops in the sort of in the mesoderm. It sort of develops in the mesoderm. So there are certain cells called as the cardiac progenitor cells. There are cells called as the cardiac progenitor. Progenitor means jo bacche hain. So these are the primitive cells which are going to ultimately form the heart. And when does this development start? It starts generally during the third week of the development. Why during the third week of the development? Because by this time the embryo has grown large enough that it cannot meet its needs of oxygen, of glucose by diffusion. So it needs a pumping system. So it needs a pumping system. So certain cells in the epiblast, they are going to go and they're going to form a primary heart field, which is horseshoe shaped. Okay, you will see an image in your Langmann or whatever book you read. So that is known as the primary heart field. And second, you have the development of the secondary heart field. Theek hai? So these are two heart fields. Bahut zyada inke baare mein, there's no need to try and understand. But the basics you can remember. Primary heart field, it gives rise to the entire left ventricle, and the secondary heart field gives rise to the right ventricle. That is one point. Okay, and portions of the atria are coming from the primary heart field, and the caudal part of the atria is also coming from the secondary heart field. The outflow tract, I'll just tell you what this is: conus cordis, truncus arteriosus, what all this is. This is coming from the secondary heart field. So what happens? I told you that. So this is the ectoderm, the neural tube, and somewhere here you have the oropharyngeal membrane. Somewhere here you have the oropharyngeal membrane. So cranial to that, you have the development of heart, which stops. Okay, cranial to that means towards the head. Eventually, this neural tube, it is going to outgrow the heart and come above it. Okay, but that happens later. Initially, that is the state. So let's try to understand it via a diagram, right? So how does the heart tube develop? How does the heart tube develop? So the mesoderm, as you guys know, that there are, so there is an epiblast, there is an hypoblast, right? So let's just simply draw it.
Right. So this is something like this. And here inside, you have two layers of mesoderm. You have two layers of mesoderm. So let's show it with yellow. There's one layer that's present here. And there's one layer that's present here. Okay. So you have two layers. So you have two layers. So the layer that is visceral is called as the splanchnopleuric mesoderm. And the layer that is somatic, it is called as the somatopleuric layer of mesoderm. Okay, please remember this is called as the lateral, these are divisions of the lateral plate mesoderm. Lateral plate mesoderm, right? Lateral plate mesoderm. So what is going to happen? And here, remember, between them, you have a connection sort of a thing here, and that is called as the septum transversum. That is called as the septum transversum. Right now, the splanchnopleuric and the somatopleuric mesoderm, what happens to them? For that, you have to understand the various layers of the heart. Okay, so this is septum transversum, this is the somatopleuric layer, and this is the splanchnopleuric layer. This is the splanchnopleuric layer. Okay, now the septum transversum, you all know it gives rise to the diaphragm. It gives rise to the diaphragm, and on the diaphragm you have the fibrous pericardium. You have the fibrous pericardium. That's right, fibrous pericardium. So there are three layers of the pericardium, right? Fibrous, and then second is serous pericardium, which is divided into two, parietal and visceral. Okay, so parietal pericardium, it is going to come from somatopleuric layer. Parietal pericardium, it is going to come from somatopleuric layer, and the splanchnopleuric layer, it is going to give rise to the visceral layer of epicardium, also called visceral layer of pericardium, also called as epicardium, also called as epicardium. Okay, not just the epicardium, the rest of the heart tube, the rest of the heart tube, which includes the cardiac musculature also, that is also going to come from the splanchnopleuric mesoderm. Okay, there's something called as the myoepicardial mantle. What is it called as? Myoepicardial mantle. So myoepicardial mantle, it gives rise to the visceral layer of the pericardium or the epicardium, as well as the myocardium, as well as the myocardium, right? And you can make out here that this is called as myoepicardium, right? So myo means myocardium, and epicardial means epicardium. So both myocardium and epicardium, they are coming from the myoepicardial mantle. Besides that, there is something here that is formed called as the cardiac jelly, right? Cardiac jelly. And this gives rise to the endocardial cushions. Not so important. Okay. So the next concept I want you to understand is the laterality of the heart. Okay. So this much is clear. That is how the what that are those are the basics of how the heart tube forms. And on inside, you are going to develop an endothelial lining. You are going to develop a lining of endothelium. Okay. Okay. Now, next thing I want you to understand is regarding the laterality of the heart. Regarding the laterality of the heart. How does the body decide that which part is going to be the left side and which part is going to be the right side? So there are certain signaling molecules that are involved here, and you guys can remember that for right-sidedness, the important molecule is monoamine oxidase, and for left-sidedness, 5-HT, that is basically serotonin, and fibroblast growth factor number 8, FGF8, and the master gene that regulates, the master gene that regulates is the PTEX2. Okay, so please remember PTEX2 is a gene. The others are signaling molecules. PTEX2 is the master gene for left-sidedness. PTEX2. ठीक है, तो लेफ्ट साइडेडनेस के लिए ये मॉलिक्यूल्स रिस्पॉन्सिबल है, राइट साइडेडनेस के लिए ये मॉलिक्यूल्स रिस्पॉन्सिबल है. नाउ वन क्वेश्चन दैट अराइजेस इज दैट व्हाई आर एसएसआरआईज टेराटोजेनिक. व्हाट आर एसएसआरआईज? सिलेक्टिव सेरोटोनिन reuptake inhibitors. I have already taken a lecture on teratogenesis, if you guys remember. So basically what these molecules are going to do is that they are going to mess up with the metabolism of serotonin. ठीक है, बस इतना समझ लो कि that they are going to mess up with the metabolism of serotonin. And because serotonin, it is important for laterality, you can have laterality defects. You can have laterality defects. Laterality means left right उल्टा हो जाए. Okay, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ देर इज अ मूवी कॉल्ड एज लक. देखिए, हैव यू एज एनीबडी सीन अ मूवी कॉल्ड लक, जिसमें आई थिंक इफ आई रिमेंबर करेक्टली संजय दत्त होता है. So what happens in that, Sanjay Dutt or Bobby Deol, I'm not sure. So what happens in that is that they shoot the person on the left side of the heart, but the person does not die. Why? Because his heart is on the right side. Wo ek dikhata hai movie mein. So that is called as dextrocardia. That is called as dextrocardia. Heart, instead of being on the left side, it is on the right side. So this orientation, this development of the heart, left side, right side, kya hoga, kis taraf ko hoga, kya hoga. So that's called as dextrocardia. And there is one more condition called as situs inversus. तो साइटस इनवर्सस में पूरी बॉडी में जो लेफ्ट साइड पर ना था वो पूरा राइट साइड को जाता है, बिल्कुल मिरर इमेज जाती है बॉडी. सो दोज आर टू कंडीशंस रिलेटेड टू लेटरलिटी. सो या दैट वाज वन पॉइंट आई वांटेड टू गेट टू यू, है ना. लैंगमैन में इसके लिए देयर इज अ क्लिनिकल बॉक्स दैट दे हैव गिवन. ठीक है, एनी डाउट्स हियर, एनी डाउट्स दैट यू हैव हियर. Okay. So let's kind of discuss what I told you here about the heart fields, because that will also help you develop a understanding, right? So let me draw a figure. Just try to understand how this is the heart. Just try to understand how this is the heart. Okay. So your primary heart field, it gives rise to some region in the body. I told you that there is a primary heart field and there is a secondary heart field. So primary heart field, it is going to give rise to this portion. Primary heart field, it is going to give rise to this portion, and this is going to develop the atria. It is going to develop the atria, and this portion which is going to develop the left ventricle. This portion which is going to develop the left ventricle. So this is coming from the primary heart field. And your secondary heart field, it gives rise to the portion that is more distal here. That includes the right ventricle, that includes the right ventricle, conus and truncus. अभी बताऊंगा क्या है ये सब, conus and truncus. So that is coming from the secondary heart field. So that is one way to remember how the various structures of the heart, they are developing from the primary and secondary heart fields. Okay, I'll just come to it. Why is it like this, and what is the funda behind this whole thing? So we'll come to that, and we'll try to make a image also for it. ठीक है, this is for the secondary heart field. चले आगे. यू अंडरस्टूड दिस बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट? ओके, नाउ लेट्स ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट हैपेंस, व्हाट एक्चुअली हैपेंस. ठीक है, यू गाइस रेडी? यू गाइस रेडी? ओके, सो आई शोन यू द स्प्लैंकनोप्लूरिक मेसोडर्म हियर, राइट. आई शोन यू द स्प्लैंकनोप्लूरिक मेसोडर्म हियर, द स्प्लैंकनोप्लूरिक मेसोडर्म. सो लेट्स इमेजिन दैट यू हैव Let's imagine that you have, okay, let's not take a black background here for this. Okay. Let's imagine that this here in let's draw it in red color. Let's imagine that this here, this is the splanchnopleuric mesoderm. This is the what? Splanchnopleuric mesoderm. I'm drawing a block of splanchnopleuric mesoderm. Now, what will start to happen here is you will have the formation of endothelium inside it. You will have the formation of endothelium inside it, and two pipes will develop. Two pipes will develop, and these are called as heart tubes. These are called as, what are they called as? Heart tubes. So you have the development of two endothelial heart tubes. So your body first tries to develop two different hearts. Your body It tries to develop two different hearts. ठीक है, so your body develops two heart tubes basically, two heart tubes. So let's draw them. Now let's take the heart tubes out and let's draw the everything related to the heart tubes and how do they develop. Okay, so let's say this was one tube. And let's say this was the other tube. So now what happens that these heart tubes, they start to merge. They start to merge. How? They start to fuse like this. कहीं कहीं से they start to develop fusions, right? They start to fuse. So now once they start to fuse, there is something that happens that kind of divides, that kind of brings them together. Okay. And all this while that it is happening, all this while that this is happening, these heart tubes, they develop segmentation. Okay. So first I'll show the segmentation. So in the first stage, I'll try to show the segmentation. So each of the heart tube, it starts to swell. This is here. Swelling is formed. Another swelling. Another swelling. Another swelling. That will happen on the other side also. That will happen on the other side also. Right? So I'm just showing it very quickly. Right? And when this happens, they start to fuse together. They start to fuse together. But they do not fuse in the lowermost portion. But they do not fuse in the lowermost portion. Why? What happens? Okay. So now I'm skipping a few stages of the development. You can imagine them fusing from here, fusing from here, fusing like this. Okay. So ultimately what happens is, these were the heart tubes you had initially. You had these two heart tubes. Ultimately what you are getting is something like this. Now, because I told you that below they are not fusing, but above they get fused. Above they get fused. So what you are essentially, okay, wait. So what you are essentially getting, what you are essentially getting is a structure that is a merged structure. ठीक है, उसमें क्या होगा? एक fusion यहाँ पे होगी, एक fusion यहाँ पे होगी, एक fusion यहाँ पे है, right? ये three, तीन fusions हो गई. And once these three fusions are done, जो fourth वाली चीज है, that is going to be a fusion, and S, it is going to be divided. Got it? Now try to understand what are these four regions that have developed. What are these four regions that have developed here in this particular structure? What are the four regions that have developed? So we'll quickly just label this and then we'll go ahead. Okay. So abhi jab shuru mein dekho, when you read about the heart in the actual image, so you always say that upper atrium and niche ventricles hai. But here it's a little opposite. Here it's a little opposite. Okay. The atria there below. ठीक है, दिस इज द प्रिमिटिव, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द प्रिमिटिव एट्रिया. दिस चेंबर इज कॉल्ड एज द प्रिमिटिव एट्रिया एंड दिस चेंबर इज कॉल्ड एज द प्रिमिटिव वेंट्रिकल. है ना, प्रिमिटिव वेंट्रिकल. सो एट्रिया एंड वेंट्रिकल, एक तो ये बीच में है और वेंट्रिकल ऊपर है और एट्रिया नीचे है. वेंट्रिकल ऊपर है और एट्रिया नीचे है. ओके, प्रिमिटिव वेंट्रिकल एंड प्रिमिटिव एट्रिया. गॉट इट? प्रिमिटिव वेंट्रिकल, प्रिमिटिव एट्रिया, क्लियर? ठीक है, अब ऊपर कौन सा है और नीचे क्या है? सो the atrium, it is going to be connected to the venous channels. So niche kya hoga? Sinus venosus. Aur upar kya hoga? The arterial channel. And upar jo hota hai usko kehte hain bulbous cortex. Isko kehte hain bulbous cortex. Abhi bataunga iske bare mein, bulbous cortex. And niche kya hoga? Sinus venosus. Because upar kuch arterial hona tha, niche kuch venous hona tha, to yahan pe sinus venosus. And more specifically this part is called as the body of the sinus venosus. Right, this is the right horn of sinus venosus and this is the left horn of sinus venosus. Right horn, left horn. Okay, so now you understand how the heart tube started to form, how the formation of the heart tube has started. Okay, so now have a look at this diagram. So this is at 18 days, that is almost 2.5 weeks, and I told you at this time the development of heart starts. Okay, so this horseshoe shaped cardiogenic area that you see that is being formed, this is called as the primary heart field. This is called as the primary heart field, and baad mein secondary heart field is also formed. So these are the two tubes I showed you. So these two endothelial tubes, they're embedded in the splanchnic mesoderm. Hai na, tabhi dekho bahar ko jo banega, जो ये स्प्लैंकनिक मेसोडर्म बनाएगा, दैट विल बी द मायोकार्डियम, दैट विल बी द मायो एंड द एपिकार्डियम, और इनसाइड देयर विल बी एंडोथेलियल लाइनिंग, देयर विल बी एंडोथेलियल लाइनिंग. सो व्हेन दीस टू ट्यूब्स फ्यूज, राइट, दे आर गोइंग टू फॉर्म द प्रिमिटिव हार्ट ट्यूब. दे आर गोइंग टू फॉर्म द प्रिमिटिव हार्ट ट्यूब. इनिशियली यू हैड द एंडोथेलियल ट्यूब्स और ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज द एंडोकार्डियल ट्यूब्स, देन यू आर गोइंग टू फॉर्म द प्रिमिटिव हार्ट ट्यूब. नाउ प्रिमिटिव हार्ट ट्यूब, यू आर गोइंग टू गेट अ डेवलपमेंट दैट यू हैव द बल्बस कॉर्डिस, प्रिमिटिव वेंट्रिकल, प्रिमिटिव एट्रियम एंड साइनस वेनोसस. है ना, अभी इसने थोड़ा डिफरेंटली दिखाया है. But yeah, this is the general idea that I wanted to give to you. Just give me one second, I'll be back. I just have to go to the washroom. Meanwhile, you guys try and understand what I've drawn.
ओके, तो अभी तक आई वॉज गोइंग वेरी स्लोली, अभी तक आई वॉज गोइंग वेरी स्लोली एंड नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू स्लोली पिकअप सम स्पीड. नाउ आई एम स्लोली गोइंग टू पिकअप सम स्पीड. ठीक है, करें स्पीड पिक, राइट, बिकॉज स्टिल हियर आई वॉन्टेड यू गाइज टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस बेसिक डेवलपमेंट. उसके बाद सब ईजी है समझना. ये जो पार्ट है दैट वॉज अ लिटिल डिफिकल्ट. इसके बाद कार्डियक लूपिंग इज अ लिटिल डिफिकल्ट एंड देन आफ्टर बिसाइड्स दैट एवरीथिंग एल्स इज ईजी. ओके, लेट्स कम बैक. नाउ राइट नाउ डोंट थिंक अबाउट कार्डियक लूपिंग. ओके, देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज कार्डियक लूपिंग, है ना, वेंट्रिकुलर लूपिंग, डी लूपिंग, कुछ कुछ होता है. बट राइट नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस. ठीक है, सो वील ड्रॉ इट फर्स्ट एंड देन आई विल शो यू इन द डायग्राम. सो वॉट इज गोइंग टू हैपन बेसिकली विद रिगार्ड्स टू दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग इज that you are going to, I just told you the segregation, I just told you how this was going to get divided into four. So can I make it here again? Let's quickly make it here. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, है ना, ऐसे बनाओ और जस्ट डिवाइड दिस इंटू टू. ओके, सो नाउ यू नो वॉट एवरीथिंग इज. ओके, नाउ जस्ट रिमेंबर दैट दिस पार्ट दैट इज द बल्बस कॉर्डिस, इट इज फर्दर डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री. So I'm just going to make it a little bigger because I have to divide it into three. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, है ना, तीन पार्ट्स में डिवाइड हो गया. Let's not take it above here. Okay, so let's divide it into three. Three divisions done. Now the uppermost part of the bulbous cordis, the uppermost part of the bulbous cordis is called as the truncus arteriosus. It is going to divide into two. So this is called as the truncus arteriosus. And it is going to give rise to what? The initial part of the pulmonary trunk and the ascending aorta. Pulmonary trunk and the ascending aorta. Right? That is the distal one third. This is called as the distal one third. Middle one third, this is called as the conus cordis. This is called as the conus cordis. Conus cordis. Conus cordis means that what is going to happen here? Conus cordis is going to be forming the outflow part of the ventricles, smooth outflow part of the ventricles, outflow of the two ventricles, the smooth outflow part, it is being formed by the conus cordis. And the proximal one third part, the proximal one third part, it forms what? The smooth, sorry, the rough inflow part of the right ventricle, the rough inflow part of the right ventricle, rough inflow of the right ventricle. Okay, rough inflow of the right ventricle. Now, right ventricle is done. So, who will form the rough inflow of the left ventricle? This one, rough inflow of left ventricle. Okay, who will form the rough, who will form the rough anterior wall of the atria, right? That is going to be formed by the primitive atrium. That is going to be formed by the primitive atrium. So this was the primitive ventricle, this was the primitive atrium. So primitive atrium will form the rough inflow of, sorry, rough inflow nahi, it is the rough anterior wall of the atria, rough anterior wall of the atria. And what is going to be formed by the sinus venosus? The smooth posterior wall of the atria. Smooth posterior wall of the atria. And it ultimately, you know that the sinus venosus, it is going to merge with the right atrium. So it forms the smooth posterior wall of the right atrium. Okay, this is the left, this is the right horn, this is the left horn. So what do the right and the left horn form? Anyone? The right and the left horn, they're also going to get merged here. So I'll just tell you what they are also going to form. ठीक है, सो फर्स्ट ट्राई एंड अंडरस्टैंड एंड डेवलप दिस मच कॉन्सेप्ट रिगार्डिंग द डेवलपमेंट. ठीक है, दिस मच कॉन्सेप्ट रिगार्डिंग द डेवलपमेंट वंस यू डेवलप यू आर गोइंग टू हैव अ वेरी गुड अंडरस्टैंडिंग. ठीक है, नाउ देर आर थ्री वेन्स ऑल्सो, इफ यू गाइज रिमेंबर देर आर थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट वेन्स इन योर बॉडी, राइट? विटलाइन वेन, अम्बिलिकल वेन एंड कॉमन कार्डिनल वेन, विच इज फॉर्म बाय द एंटीरियर एंड पोस्टीरियर कार्डिनल वेन. ठीक है, देर आर थ्री वेन्स ऑन बोथ साइड्स. यू नो यू हैव थ्री वेन्स ऑन बोथ साइड्स, विटलाइन,
This is the vitelline, this is the umbilical, this is the common cardinal, right? And common cardinal further divides into two, anterior and posterior. Okay, so let's focus a little bit there on that development part. So again, I'll have to draw the heart tube. This time what I'll do is I'll divide this into three automatically. So this is the three parts of the bulbus. Next, primitive atrium, primitive ventricle, and primitive ventricle, primitive atrium, and the sinus venosus. Okay. Now, what happens? So I'll tell you a little bit about the various structures that are separating them. So this was the bulbus. This was the bulbus. Ye upar kya tha? This was called as the bulbus. And what was this called as the primitive ventricle? This was called as the primitive ventricle. So between the bulbus and the ventricle, this hole that is there, what do you call this hole? What do you call this hole? So this hole is being called as the bulboventricular sulcus. Am I right? Bulbo, keh sakta usko bulbo ventricular sulcus, bulbo ventricular sulcus. Kyun? Because it is present between the bulbus and the ventricle, primitive ventricle and the bulbus. Clear? That is clear? Okay. Now primitive ventricle is done. Primitive ventricle is done. Now what will happen? You have to draw the another. So this was the primitive atrium, right? And this is the sinus venosus. So between the atrium and between the sinus, what is going to be there? Between the atrium and between the sinus. So you will call this the sinoatrial. You will call this sinoatrial. Kya bologe isko? Sinoatrial. Right? Let's call it sinoatrium. Sinoatrial sulcus. Sulcus kello for now, but it's not actually a sulcus. And that is why you now know that why the SA node is called as the SA node. Why the SA node is called as the SA node. Sinoatrial word kaha se hai na? Sinoatrial. Right? This is correct. This is correct. Now, what is one that is left between the ventricle and the atrium? So I told you the primitive ventricle, what does it form? Primitive ventricle, it forms the rough inflow of the right ventricle and rough anterior wall of the atria is being formed by the primitive atrium. So how do you divide this? Okay, so see, blood, it is going to enter from here. Blood, it is going to enter from here, venous blood. It will go through the sinus venosus. It will pass like this. Now in the atrium, the atria will have to be divided into two. The atria, they will have to be divided into two. Obviously, you will have to divide the atria into two. How will you do that? You will make a division here. Right? So which atrium will this be? This will be the right atrium. This will be the right atrium. Clear? How this is the right atrium? Ye samajh aaya? Right atrium kaise hai ye? Okay. So after that, which atrium is going to this? Which atrium is this? This is the left atrium. And left atrium should be connected to the left ventricle. Left atrium should be connected to the left ventricle. And when the folding happens, so this bulboventricular sulcus, you will have the formation of the interventricular septum, etc. And you know that upar jo hai, wo right ventricle wala part hai, right? You have the inflowing part of the right ventricle. Ye wala right ventricle banana tha, right? Usse upar kya ban raha tha? Outflow of the ventricles, right? So both these ventricles, they are going to have their outflow like this. Okay. Now let's come back to this diagram and try to understand everything. Okay. So you can see here that you have the anterior and the posterior cardinal veins joining to form the common cardinal vein. Right umbilical vein, right vitelline vein. So they are going to merge with the right horn. Left horn may similarly. Then the body, then the common atrium. Okay. Between the sinus venosus and the atrium, you can see you have the sinoatrial orifice. You have the sinoatrial orifice. Achha, I forgot to tell you the name of this. Very obvious name. Hai na? Atrium or ventricle ke beech mein. So this will be called as atrioventricular. This will be called as atrioventricular groove or atrioventricular orifice. Na? This is the atrioventricular orifice. And it is also very important, atrioventricular orifice. So now, again, let's go back here. So you can interpret this diagram now. You can make this arrangement of the tube. Hai na? Upper truncus arteriosus, I see it is dividing into two arteries, right? Dorsal aorta and pulmonary trunk. Ye truncus arteriosus ho gaya. Common outflow tract ho gaya, middle one third of the conus. Proximal one third ho gaya. Outflow of the right ventricle, inflow of the right ventricle. Primitive ventricle is going to form the left ventricle. कॉमन एट्रियम को दो में डिवाइड करो, ये साइनो एट्रियल नोड, तो ऊपर यहाँ पे क्या होगा, सॉरी नीचे ये क्या होगा, राइट एट्रियम, ये क्या होगा लेफ्ट एट्रियम, ये साइनो एट्रियल ऑरिफिस, तभी राइट एट्रियम और साइनस वेनोसस जहाँ जुड़ते हैं दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द, वहां पे क्या बन जाता है साइनस नोड, और ये साइनस वेनोसस दिस इज गोइंग टू फॉर्म द आउटफ्लो. ओके सो दैट इज अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर एंड व्हाट व्हाट एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग टू डेवलप. ओके सो सी इट इज रिटन हियर, असेंडिंग एओर्टा एंड पल्मोनरी ट्रंक, आउटफ्लो ऑफ द राइट एंड लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल्स, प्रिमिटिव राइट वेंट्रिकल ट्रैबुकुलेटेड पार्ट, यानी कि इनफ्लो रफ इनफ्लो, प्रिमिटिव लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकुलर, है ना, प्रिमिटिव एट्रियम पार्टीशन हो जाता है इनटू राइट एंड लेफ्ट एट्रियम, ऊपर लेफ्ट एट्रियम नीचे राइट एट्रियम. ठीक है, बॉडी ऑफ द साइनस वेनोसस इट गेट्स अब्सॉर्ब इनटू द, बॉडी ऑफ द साइनस वेनोसस इट गेट्स अब्सॉर्ब इनटू द राइट एट्रियम बॉडी. ठीक है, ये था आपका रफ पार्ट ऑफ द राइट एट्रियम, साइनस वेनोसस इट गेट्स अब्सॉर्ब हियर, इट गेट्स अब्सॉर्ब हियर, एंड बिकॉज इट गेट्स अब्सॉर्ब व्हाट विल हैपन, बिकॉज इट गेट्स अब्सॉर्ब व्हाट विल हैपन, देयर विल बी अ रफ एंटीरियर पार्ट एंड पीछे एक पोस्टीरियर पार्ट होगा दैट इज फॉर्म्ड बाय द साइनस वेनोसस. सो द बॉडी ऑफ द साइनस वेनोसस इट इज फॉर्मिंग द स्मूथ पार्ट ऑफ द राइट एट्रियम, द लेफ्ट हॉर्न इट इज गोइंग टू डिसअपियर, द लेफ्ट हॉर्न इट इज गोइंग टू डिसअपियर एंड अल्टीमेटली फॉर्म द कोरोनरी साइनस. On the right side, the right horn of the sinus venosus, it is also absorbed into the right atrium. Okay, the right common cardinal vein forms the superior vena cava. The right umbilical vein, it obviously disappears, and the right vitelline vein forms the caudal part of the cranial part of the inferior vena cava. So that is why the inferior vena cava, superior vena cava, and coronary sinus they are opening into the right atrium. ये बात समझ आई कि नहीं समझ आई? Just try to understand this. This was the common atrium. This was the sinus venosus. And this was the body, and these were the two horns. These were the two horns. So, what is the fate of everything? What is the fate of everything? See, I told you atrium it is divided into two. यहाँ से ऐसे divide कर दो. So, let's forget about the part that is above. Let's in fact erase it. है ना? ये इनके बीच में वो बन जाएगा interatrial septum. अभी नहीं बना रहे. ठीक है? तो ये क्या है? Right atrium. तो right atrium का ये क्या है? Anterior part. This is the anterior rough part. And smooth part is the sinus venosus. So sinus venosus it is going to merge with the right atrium. Okay. So kya ban gaya? Let's merge them. So kya banega inse mila ke? Right atrium. Now right atrium it is going to receive two horns, right horn and left horn. Ye jo left horn hai, ye to waisi gayab ho jata hai. Left horn it disappears, does not exist. Okay. Why? Because left horn it is going to form the coronary sinus. It will form the coronary sinus. So please remember, left horn it is important also. It forms the coronary sinus where all the coronary veins are going to drain. All the veins of the heart they are going to drain through the left horn. Okay. Left umbilical vein or right umbilical vein में से कौन सी बच जाती है? अच्छा यहाँ पे तीन veins थी ना, common cardinal, umbilical and vitelline. Okay. So which is left? So you all remember, left is left, right is not there. Left is left, left umbilical vein is left, right umbilical vein disappears. So the left, on the right side, the right common cardinal vein, it forms the superior vena cava, the initial part of the superior vena cava, and this right vitelline vein, it forms the what? The cranial part of the inferior vena cava, and this is also ultimately going to emerge to the right atrium. So now what are the three important openings in the right atrium that are developing from here? Superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, and coronary sinus. Rough anterior part is being formed by primitive atrium. Smooth posterior part is being formed by body of the sinus venosus and the right horn of the sinus venosus, because right horn is also merging now here. So that is going to merge. So that is the development of the atria. That is the development of the atria. Any doubts? Any doubts here? Any doubts here? No? No doubts so far. So if you guys are liking the lecture, please do remember to hit the like button on this video. Huh? Okay. Now that is more or less what you need to understand here regarding the development of the heart. The rest of the things are a little bit okay. Let's try to talk about this cardiac looping. Okay, so normally your heart undergoes looping towards the right side, so that is called as dextro looping. Kya bolte hai isko? Dextro looping. Okay, cardiac looping. What I want you to do for cardiac looping, because see, cardiac looping is a 3D thing. It is a 3D3. So cardiac looping is very difficult for me to explain on a whiteboard. And that is going to be unfair to you if I try to explain it here. So what I want you to do is, on my Telegram channel, I had sent a link. I had sent a link. And in that link, there is a 3D animation of the cardiac looping. So just go ahead and have a look at that. So you will understand how the looping of the heart occurs. ठीक है? Because see, what is the goal? What is the goal? Tell me. अभी क्या है? The atria they are below, the ventricles are above. There is no left right, है ना? So atria they are going to go above and they are going to come posteriorly. ये ventricles थे, right? You see, that's why it's very difficult to explain. Because it has to be imagined, right? So the atria are initially above. The atria have to be above. Initially they are below. So the atria, they go and they come here behind. From behind they come above the ventricles. The ventricles go down. ठीक है? और उसी तरीके से उसमें राइट एंड लेफ्ट भी फॉर्म होता है. राइट एंड लेफ्ट भी फॉर्म होता है. सो दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट. ठीक है? समझ रहे हो ये बात? थोड़ा बहुत डू यू हैव अ ओरिएंटेशन वीडियो गाइस, वॉच दैट वीडियो. देयर इज एन जस्ट गो टू यूट्यूब एंड हैव अ लुक एट द 3D एनिमेशन ऑफ कार्डियक लूपिंग. एंड आफ्टर दैट जस्ट रीड अ पैराग्राफ ऑन कार्डियक लूपिंग फ्रॉम एनी वेयर, यू विल अंडरस्टैंड इट. ठीक है? एंड डेक्स्ट्रोकार्डिया इज बेसिकली एन अबनॉर्मैलिटी ऑफ कार्डियक लूपिंग. ठीक है? गॉट दिस? सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज डेक्स्ट्रो लूपिंग. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज डेक्स्ट्रो लूपिंग. सो कैन वी टॉक अबाउट द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द कार्डियक सेप्टा नाउ? कैन वी टॉक अबाउट द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द कार्डियक सेप्टा? Rest you just give a read of everything and you will understand a lot of things. Okay. Let's go to the development of the cardiac septa. Yes, this is for the first prof. This is for students who are absolutely in the first prof. Chalo. Let's try to understand the septa. So there are three septa that you have to understand. Interatrial septum, interventricular septum, and the conotruncal, the conotruncal septum, which is also called as the spiral septum, also called as the spiral septum. ठीक है? So first I'll do the spiral septum with you guys. First I will do the spiral septum, then we will do the interventricular septum, and then we'll do the interatrial septum. Okay. So spiral septum, what you have to understand, this is the spiral septum. ठीक है? दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द आयोटिको पल्मोनरी सेप्टम, बिकॉज इट इज बिटवीन द आयोटा एंड द पल्मोनरी ट्रंक, और समटाइम्स इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज द स्पायरल सेप्टम. नाउ वाई इज इट कॉल्ड एज द स्पायरल सेप्टम? फॉर दैट यू हैव टू लुक एट दिस इमेज एंड ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. ठीक है? सी द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल इज ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड. द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल इट इज ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड, बट द आयोटा इट कर्व्स लाइक दिस एंड इट इमर्जेस हियर एंड देन इट गोज डाउन. Okay, so it goes towards the right side. So if I give you an image of the heart, or if I give you a specimen of the heart, the aorta is slightly towards the right side because from the left it is spiraling towards the right. Okay, so what is the so you can see here the aorta, it follows a spiral course, and the pulmonary trunk similarly coming from the right side, it spirals towards the left here. See, initially what was there? Initially what was there? This side is the right ventricle. This side is the left ventricle. ठीक है? तो लेफ्ट से निकल रही थी ये, बट वेन यू सी द फाइनल इमर्जेंस, द आयोटा इट इज इमर्जिंग ऑन द विच साइड? इट इज इमर्जिंग टुवर्ड्स द राइट साइड, एंड द अदर वन इट इज इमर्जिंग टुवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट साइड. सो दैट हैपेंस, एंड यू कैन सी द स्पाइरल कोर्स. दिस डायग्राम इज अ लिटिल बिट एक्सप्लेनेटरी. इट्स काइंड ऑफ लुक्स लाइक अ सैंड क्लॉक, है ना? अगेन दिस इज समथिंग दैट वुड बेटर बी एक्सप्लेन्ड इफ यू सी एन इमेजिनेशन ऑफ हाउ द ब्लड फ्लोज हियर. But to understand, you can see here that initially aorta was above, that is, I was saying towards the right, and pulmonary trunk it was below. Then when it is spiraling, they are coming parallel to each other like this, and then going like this. Okay, so do you understand the flow? Initially, aise the. Let's take two pens and show you. Initially, they were like this. Okay, And then they started spiraling. Then they started spiraling, and later they became like this. Okay, so you understand how spiraling is occurring. ये आगे था, you were going above, you were going above, you were going above, and then ये आगे आ गया, right? So that is how spiraling is happening. So just get a feel of it, and you will understand what is there. So इसीलिए बीच में जो ये septum present है, this septum that is present in between, that is not a straight septum, it is a spiraled septum. That is why it is called as the spiral septum. Now, where does it develop from? It develops from the neural crest cells. It develops from the migration of neural crest cells. Okay. ठीक है. So, if there's any defect in the neural crest cells, you may have developmental defects in the aortic or the aortopulmonary or the spiral septum. You can have defects of its development, right? They are relatively common also. Now, you have to understand a few of these defects. You have to understand a few of these defects. And to help you guys understand these defects, let's break it up a little. Okay. Come on, let's do this. Right. So, what was expected from you guys? If you have a look at this, what do you want ultimately? You want the pulmonary artery and you want the aorta. Normally, you want them to spiral properly through the septum, and you want half of it to be occupied by the pulmonary artery. And you want half of it to be occupied by the pulmonary aorta. Am I right? That is what you want. Let's say this is it. So you want, depending on from where you are seeing, let's say this is what was expected. And for the spiral septum. Okay, this in red I have drawn the ascending aorta, and in blue I have drawn the pulmonary trunk. Now, if there is a failure in development, there are three possibilities. There are three possibilities. Okay. There are three possibilities, and let's try to understand each one of them. Okay. So in one possibility, what happens is this is the thing that is happening. In the second possibility, so can you guys point out what is the major defect in each of these? Can you guys help me understand ki kya ho raha hai? What am I trying to show in each of these? Okay, so the first effect, it is called as an overriding aorta. ठीक है, अभी बात करते हैं उसके बारे में. So in the first effect, as you can make out, the aorta, it is occupying much more of the region as compared to the pulmonary trunk. So the conotruncal septum, the spiral septum, sorry, not the conotruncal septum, the spiral septum, it is deviated towards the pulmonary trunk. It is pushed towards the pulmonary trunk. ठीक है. Okay, right. Second thing that is happening is that they have exchanged positions. There is an exchange of positions, and this is known as transposition of great vessels, dextro transposition of great vessels, great arteries, DTGA, dextro transposition of great arteries. Transposition matlab ulte ho gaye. And this last one, it is a, so the septum has not formed at all. The septum has not formed at all. Okay. That is one update. So this one, so sorry, that is one possibility here. Okay. That this is called as the patent ductus arteriosus. Sorry, not the patent ductus arteriosus, patent truncus arteriosus, right? This is called as the patent truncus arteriosus. That means that there is no septum and there is a complete mixing of the blood of the pulmonary trunk and the ascending aorta. Is that clear? Is that clear? Okay, so in case you missed it, let's revise it. Okay, so can you identify the defect for me here? Can you identify the defect for me here? Let's have a look at the image also. So can you guys help me identify the defect? I want you guys to tell me which defect is this. Which defect is this? What is the name of the defect? Don't worry, this session will also be available as a recorded session. Even if you missed it, that's something that is okay, but try to watch it from here. Okay. Yes, you can obviously see a ventricular septal defect. So I just told you about three, right? So the name of this defect is called as tetralogy of Fallot. Tetralogy of Fallot. क्या कहते हैं इसको? Tetralogy of Fallot. TOF. Now, what are some important things that you can remember here? What are some important things that you can make out in this diagram? How do you identify it? Okay. First, you can see that the pulmonary trunk, it is very small. Pulmonary trunk, it is very small. Whereas the aorta, it is so big. The aorta, it is so big. Right? So you can make out that what would have happened here? What would have happened here? The pulmonary trunk, it is very small. Whereas the aorta, it is very big. Okay. So this is called as an overriding aorta. This is called as an overriding aorta. Okay. And that means that the septum, it is deviated towards the pulmonary trunk. It is deviated towards the pulmonary trunk. Because of that, this pulmonary valve, it is stenosed. Stenosed means narrowed. Okay. So you have a stenotic pulmonary valve or pulmonary stenosis. Right? That is how I'm writing it. Pulmonary stenosis. Third thing, you can make out because the heart has to apply extra effort to pump blood here. The heart, it is not able to pump blood here because there is stenosis, the vessel is small, the pressure will also be less. So the heart, it has to give a lot of extra pressure. And right ventricle, because of that, there is hypertrophy. Dekho, right ventricle, it has become almost as thick as the left ventricle. So that is called as right ventricular hypertrophy. And the fourth feature is a ventricular septal defect called as VSD. Now, why does ventricular septal defect occur? Because later I will tell you in the development of the interventricular septum that let's say this here, this is the spiral septum. Let's say here, this is the spiral septum. Okay. Below it, the part of the septum that is known as the septum here, that is the septum here. I'll just tell you later what it is. Okay. This septum. Okay. Let's understand it here only so that you guys don't have a confusion later on. So this is called as the bulbar septum. This is called as the bulbar septum, right? And both the bulbar septum and the spiral septum, both of them develop from the neural crest cells. Both of them develop from the न्यूरल क्रेस्ट सेल्स, बोथ ऑफ देम, है ना? ये भी न्यूरल क्रेस्ट सेल्स है, ये भी न्यूरल क्रेस्ट सेल्स है. सो इफ देयर इज एन अबनॉर्मैलिटी ऑफ द स्पाइरल सेप्टम, इट मे बी अकॉम्पनीड बाय एन अबनॉर्मैलिटी ऑफ द बल्बर सेप्टम, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट यू विल हैव अ डिफेक्ट ऑफ द इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर सेप्टम. बिकॉज ऑफ दैट यू विल हैव अ डिफेक्ट ऑफ द इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर सेप्टम. ठीक है, सो जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड इट हियर, आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट लेटर अगेन व्हेन आई एम डूइंग द इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर सेप्टम, राइट? ओके. Next, this. What is this image showing you? What can you make out in this particular image? Can you make out anything in this image? What can you make out? There's a very huge blunder that is there. Okay, this looks like a normal heart to someone who is not studying MBBS, है ना? अपने दोस्तों को दिखाना, बोलना ये हार्ट नॉर्मल है, राइट? शो इट टू योर फ्रेंड्स एंड देन सी द नॉन मेडिकल फ्रेंड्स एंड देन सी द काइंड ऑफ मिस्टेक्स दे विल मेक हियर. ओके, सो सिमिलरली हियर यू हैव टू सी दैट दिस इज द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल, दिस इज द राइट वेंट्रिकल. राइट वेंट्रिकल इज ओपनिंग इनटू द एओर्टा एंड द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल इज ओपनिंग इनटू द पल्मोनरी ट्रंक, है ना? सो देयर इज नो स्पाइरलिंग दैट इज अकरिंग, व्हिच मींस दैट द कोनोट्रेंकल सेप्टम, इट इज नॉट स्पाइरल्ड, इट इज स्ट्रेट. Conotruncal septum, it is not spiraled, it is straight. So here, instead of the blue coming above, blue has come below only, and red has come above. Okay. So this is called as dextro transposition of great arteries. Transposition क्यों? ये वाली artery इधर आनी थी और ये वाली इधर आनी थी, तो ये उठ के इधर आ गई और ये उठ के इधर आ गई. Okay. So that is why it is called as transposition of great arteries. And how do you identify it? It's fairly simple to identify. Transposition of great arteries. लास्ट दिस वन, अब तो पता होगा सबको ये, यू ऑल वुड नो अबाउट दिस है ना, यू ऑल नो दिस, व्हाट इज दिस कॉल्ड एज, इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ पेटेंट ट्रंकस आर्टेरियोसिस, और सिंपली इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ ट्रंकस आर्टेरियोसिस, सिंपली इट इज कॉल्ड एज ट्रंकस आर्टेरियोसिस, क्या बोलते हैं इसको, देखो सी देर इज नो डिविजन हियर, देर इज नो सेप्टम, देर इज नो सेप्टम, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज ट्रंकस आर्टेरियोसिस, एंड वॉट विल हैपन एज अ रिजल्ट, एज अ रिजल्ट देर इज गोइंग टू बी मिक्सिंग ऑफ ब्लड, एंड बिकॉज देर विल बी मिक्सिंग ऑफ ब्लड ऑक्सीजनेशन विल नॉट बी प्रॉपर, सो दिस विल लीड टू साइनोसिस, एंड एज आई टोल्ड यू इफ द सेप्टम इज नॉट फॉर्म, इफ द स्पाइरल सेप्टम इज नॉट फॉर्म, the bulbar septum will also not be formed, so this septum is also missing, so you will also have ventricular septal defect, okay, you will also have ventricular septal defect, right. Now one more thing about truncus arteriosus is how do you correct it, what is the repair, na? So there's a name for this repair, it's called as the Rastelli repair. Isme kya karte hain, you take a, you put a artificial septum and you put a new pulmonary valve or an artery properly, theek hai, so it's a surgical repair. And that is called as the Rastelli repair. क्या कहते हैं इसको, Rastelli. This is repaired by what is called as the Rastelli repair. Clear? Is that clear to you? Rastelli repair. Okay. So are you clear with the various defects of the septum here, of the spiral septum? Any doubts regarding aorticopulmonary or spiral septum and its defects? No doubts? Okay. So let's talk about the interventricular septum. Before I talk about this, this was the primitive ventricle. Kya tha ye? Primitive ventricle. This was the primitive atrium. This was the primitive atrium divided into two. ठीक है, यहाँ पे राइट वेंट्रिकल, यहाँ पे लेफ्ट एट्रियम, और ये रफ इनफ्लो ऑफ लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल, तो लेफ्ट एट्रियम इट इज ओपनिंग इनटू द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल, राइट, सो एट दिस प्लेस हियर इन द सेंटर यू विल हैव द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ अ स्ट्रक्चर, एंड आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू द नेम ऑफ दिस, दिस इज नोन एज द एट्रियो वेंट्रिकुलर ऑरिफिस, दिस इज नोन एज द एट्रियो वेंट्रिकुलर ऑरिफिस, क्या बोलते हैं इसको, एवी लिख देता हूँ ना सिंपली, this is called as the AV orifice, am I right, this is called as the AV orifice, theek hai, now since this is called as the AV orifice, iske andar kya hota hai, there is a development of two cushions here, cushions matlab there are some outpouchings that develop here like this, theek hai, there is a dorsal cushion and a ventral cushion that develops, and these are called as AV cushions, these are called as AV cushions, theek hai, they are important, AV cushions aise develop hote hain, ठीक है, नाउ ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट आई हैव टेकन अ सेक्शन, ये लेफ्ट लेफ्ट एट्रियम है, लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल है, सो नाउ यू हैव टू फॉर्म द इंटरवेंट्रिकुलर सेप्टम, ओके, सो लेट्स ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट वी डू इज वी टेक अ सेक्शन दैट इज पासिंग ऑन द प्लेन वेयर द सेप्टम हैज टू डेवलप, ओके, क्या मतलब, ये आपका राइट एट्रियम, राइट ऐसे आपका ये बन गया है ना, तो यहां पे सेप्टम डेवलप होना है, सो आई एम कटिंग द हार्ट लाइक दिस एंड आई एम लुकिंग फ्रॉम हियर, I'm cutting the heart like this and I'm looking from here. So what I will see? I will see an atrium above. I will see the ventricle below. I will see the aorta here, right? In between, what will I see? I will see the atrioventricular orifice and here I will see two cushions. I will see two cushions, right? Now, above here, this was this distal part. This was truncus arteriosus. So truncus arteriosus, it is divided by the spiral septum, right? It is divided by the spiral septum. And niche, what is this? Since I have cut a cross section, I will be able to see the muscle. So this is the muscular wall. This is the muscular wall or the myocardium developing from the splanchnopleuric layer of the mesoderm. So now what happens? This muscle wall, it starts to give part to some of the septum. It starts to give some proliferation, right? And that proliferation will actually form some part of the septum. So let's draw the septum in the rainbow color. Okay. Pride week hai, pride month hai. So let's go with the rainbow color. Okay. So see here. Aisa kuch part. This initial part. This is called as the muscular part. This is called as the muscular part. Kya bolte hai isko? Muscular part of the septum. Okay, so it is from the muscular proliferation of the ventricular cavity. Right? Upar thoda sa jo part hota hai, some of the part that is present above, some of the part that is present above, this is the bulbous cortex. So this is called as the bulbar part. This is called as the bulbar part. So I'm putting it with yellow here. This is the bulbar part and it is developed from the neural crest cells. I've already told you that it also develops from the neural crest cells just like the spiral septum. And because it is developing from the neural crest cells, both of these can be very commonly affected together. Okay. Lastly, you have the membranous part. And membranous part, please keep in mind, it develops from the AV cushions. Membranous part. It is going to develop from the AV cushion. So there are three parts to the septum: membranous, muscular, and bulbous. Bulbar part is developing from neural crest cells, which are also coming and developing the spiral septum. Muscular part, it is muscular proliferation of the muscular walls. And the membranous part, it is developing from the atrioventricular cushions. That is the development of the interventricular septum. Done? Understood? Interventricular septum. Have you guys understood the development of the interventricular septum? So I think we have covered everything apart from the interatrial septum. Okay, start from here. We did this, did this, did this, talked about this, this, this. Okay, so last thing to talk about is the interatrial septum. Interatrial septum. The development of the interventricular septum is very important. Okay. Interatrial septum is relatively much more simpler. I mean, in the sense that the questions that are formed are not too difficult or too deep. Right? Interventricular septum, say there's been a question that has come where they've asked you to identify the membranous part of the interventricular septum in a gross image. Okay, so the question that had come in an exam very recently was the membranous. So what they'd done was they'd given you a image of the a heart, they'd given you an image of the heart, right? And from there they had given you an image of the septum, and basically they were expecting you to identify the membranous part of the atrioventricular septum and to tell where it is developing from, to tell where it is developing from. So that was the question that came in a recent AIIMS examination. Right, can we start with the interatrial septum? And just let's take a 2 minute break. I'll be back, just let me get some water for myself. Just give me 2 minutes, right?
Okay, so we're back, and let's continue from here. Let's take it up from here.
Interradial septum. Interatrial septum. So let's try to understand what is happening. Before I explain interatrial septum to you, I'll go back here and tell you about the AV cushions. AV cushions. So both these cushions, they're going to come close together, and here they're going to form a septum that is called as the septum intermedium. They're going to form a septum called as the septum intermedium. Septum intermedium. Right, and the reason I have kept this image is the reason I have kept this particular image is that I want you to imagine everything in 3D. Okay, I'll make a diagram that is obviously 2D, but I always want you to remember that the septum, it is not a straight line. It is not a straight line. It is a complete circle. It is a complete circle, right? Like this. It's a complete disc, not a, just a straight line or a straight surface. Okay, it's a complete disc that is present between the right atrium and the left atrium. Because see now, try and understand. This is the right atrium, this is the left atrium, and what you look at is the cross section, but otherwise they are completely closed chambers. So in between them you have to have a proper disc. So in between them you have to have a proper disc to separate them. Okay, so that is one concept you will learn from here. But before I discuss this diagram, I want you to understand the basics, and that you can do in the cross section very well. Okay, so let's draw it a little. Let's say this is your atrium. Okay, I haven't been able to draw it very well. Slowly, slowly, I think my diagrams are becoming better. Okay, let's say this is the atrium. And here I told you that this was the atrioventricular orifice. And here the cushions, they are going to merge. And here you are going to have something. And that is basically the septum intermedium. This is called as the septum intermedium. Why is this called as septum intermedium? Because the cushions have merged here. And it is present here. Okay. Now, there are a few other septums that you will hear about. There are a few other septums you will hear about. So let me just write them for you. You will hear about septum intermedium. You will hear about septum sporium. You will hear about septum primum. And you will hear about septum secundum. These are everything that you are going to hear about. So, ye sab sunoge tum. तो ये चार सेप्टम के नाम आएंगे अभी है ना इसमें हमारी डेवलपमेंट. सो लेट्स ट्राई एंड गो वन बाय वन. लेट्स ट्राई एंड गो वन बाय वन. सो दिस साइड इज द राइट साइड एंड दिस साइड इज द लेफ्ट साइड. सो ट्राई एंड अंडरस्टैंड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ स्टोरी. ट्राई एंड अंडरस्टैंड इट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ स्टोरी. ओके, व्हेन द हार्ट इज डेवलपिंग, व्हेन द हार्ट इज डेवलपिंग, द प्रॉब्लम इज दैट. सो इन द लेफ्ट एट्रियम व्हाट इज द ओपनिंग? You're going to receive blood from the lungs. You're going to receive blood from the lungs. But during this time, the lungs, they are not very functional. The lungs, they are not very functional. Very common. They're absolutely useless. So they don't give any blood to the left atrium. They don't give any blood to the left atrium. Right? So left atrium, it is very greedy. It wants blood all the time. It wants blood. So what it does is, it tries to always take blood from the right atrium. It tries to always take blood from the right atrium. Now to do that, there is, but the right atrium, it feels that he is taking advantage of me. Right atrium, he feels that left atrium is taking advantage of me. So what right atrium says is, I will form a wall. I will form a wall. जैसे आपने ट्रंप का सुना होगा ना, ट्रंप बीच में मेक्सिको के साथ दीवार बनाना चाह रहा है. मेक्सिको नहीं, सॉरी, मेहिको है ना, मेहिको के साथ दीवार बनाना चाह रहा है. तो सिमिलरली द राइट एट्रियम इज लाइक ट्रंप. He wants to create a wall. But left atrium says, I want to get blood till the time the lungs are not functional. So left atrium does not want a wall. Left atrium, it does not want a wall. Now because of this conflict, what happens? You have the development of something called as the septum primum. You have the, so septum primum is that the right atrium tries to develop a wall. The right atrium, it tries to develop a wall, and the wall grows down, grows down, grows down, grows down. So he says that how I can stop my flow of blood is I join the upper wall with the septum intermedium. So he tries to form a wall, and this is his first attempt. This is his first attempt. So this is called as septum primum. This is called as septum primum. However, obviously, it takes time to develop the wall, right? I'm writing SP for septum primum. Okay. It takes time to develop a wall. So he's not able to develop it fully, and there is a foramen that is left. Okay. And this foramen is called as the foramen primum. This is called as the primary foramen or the foramen primum. Okay. So how does the blood flow during this time? Very easily, like this. Okay. Right. That's happening. Now what happens? The left atrium is the right atrium is very determined. I will close this bloody foramen primum. I will bloody close this foramen primum. So I want to complete my septum primum. So what he does is he tries to complete it. Tries to complete it by growing it downward, growing it downward, growing it downward, and he manages to do it. Manages to do it. But the left atrium is very, very, very smart. Left atrium, what he does is he causes apoptosis. Okay, when I say he or she here, I'm just making a story for you guys. Okay, this is actually controlled by other molecules. So he causes this to develop apoptosis. यहाँ पे he starts to develop apoptosis. यहाँ पे मतलब septum के cells का apoptosis करा देता है. And because of that apoptosis, there are certain perforations that develop here. There are certain perforations that develop here. What develops? Perforations. So the septum primum, there are certain holes in it. There are certain holes in it. Okay, so now this time the septum primum, it has again opened. The blood is again flowing. Left atrium is still successful in its own scheme. Left atrium is still successful in its own scheme. And for the sake of simplicity, we will make this whole septum primum disappear. Okay, for the sake of simplicity. Okay. So now this is the septum primum. Okay. Now what happens? Now what happens? The right atrium, it says that कुछ करना पड़ेगा. I will have to take a second attempt. I will have to take a second attempt, है ना? So देखो inter atrial septum भी dropper है. Inter atrial septum it is a dropper. Okay. So what it does is it drops another septum and this time it calls it septum secundum. This time it calls it septum secundum and he says this time I will make it very rigid. This time I will make it very rigid. Septum primum was very weak. It was easily apoptosed. Septum secundum, it is very rigid. It's difficult to apoptose. Okay. And what is going to happen here is that there is a right and left venous valve here, right? That is coming from the sinus venosus. And so this is the right venous valve and this is the left venous valve. And they're going to merge and form the septum spurium, right? And it ultimately gets incorporated into the septum secundum only, right? I'm just leaving that story. I don't want to bring a third septum into this love story. But just telling you for the sake of completion that this is also happening. Okay. So septum secundum, but still, the left atrium, because it does not have any pressure, this septum primum, it was very weak. So how does the blood flow? The blood is able to flow like this. The blood is able to flow like this. The blood, it is able to push. The blood, it is able to kind of push the septum primum and flow across like this. Right? It is able to push the septum primum. Okay, get it? Because here you have pressure. See, left atrium, it has very low pressure initially because no blood is coming from here, but here you are continuously getting blood from the vena cavas. Hai na? You are continuously getting blood here. So pressure, it will be high here and low there. So blood is able to flow. But the left atrium, the moment birth happens, the lungs, they start to take a breath. The lungs open up, the circulation in the lungs open up. And then here, bhai, bahut sara blood aa jata. There is a whole lot of blood that comes in. There's a whole lot of blood that comes in. Okay. So what is happening? What is going to happen in that case when the blood starts to come in? The left atrium, now it does not want anything to do with the right atrium. Because now it knows that it has superior blood. It has oxygenated blood. So now it does not want the bad, ganda sa deoxygenated blood. Now it says, I am getting my oxygenated blood. I will close this. I will close this. So it applies pressure here. And obviously, septum primum, it is like a flap. It will get closed. Okay, it will get closed. But septum secundum, right atrium had made the septum secundum so rigid so that it does not get apoptosed. But now it is not able to move also. So because of this, this gets embedded here. Septum primum, there's a functional closure of the foramen ovale. Okay, I forgot to tell you, जो पहले राइट से ब्लड आ रहा था ना, दैट वाज थ्रू फोरामेन ओवेल और ऑस्टियम सेकेंडम. ओके, तो क्या डेवलप हो गया? सेप्टम प्राइमम से ये हो गया क्लोजर, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस देर विल बी अ सॉर्ट ऑफ अ बेंडिंग, है ना, कैसे बेंड हो जाएगा, दिस विल बेंड लाइक दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ, ऐसे थोड़ा बेंड सा हो जाएगा, ठीक है. सो देर इज अ डिप्रेशन हियर, देर इज अ डिप्रेशन दैट इज विजिबल फ्रॉम द राइट एट्रियम, दिस डिप्रेशन इज कॉल्ड एज द फोसा ओवैलिस, दिस डिप्रेशन इज कॉल्ड एज द फोसा ओवैलिस, एंड दिस कवरिंग अराउंड इट दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द लिम्बस ऑफ द फोसा ओवैलिस. नाउ हैव अ लुक एट इट इन 3D, ठीक है, क्या था, सेप्टम प्राइमम, इट वॉज गोइंग डाउन ग्रोइंग डाउन ग्रोइंग डाउन, इट लेड टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ फोरामेन प्राइमम, राइट, बट अबाउट द टाइम वेन राइट वेंट्रिकल वॉज एबल टू क्लोज इट, लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल इट मेड होल्स अबव, सो दिस वॉज कॉल्ड एज फोरामेन सेकेंडम, राइट. वेन फोरामेन सेकेंडम वॉज फॉर्म, देन द राइट एट्रियम ट्राइड टू अगेन फिल दिस होल बाय द हेल्प ऑफ सेप्टम सेकेंडम, बट स्टिल ब्लड वॉज एबल टू फ्लो लाइक दिस बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ फोरामेन ओवेल. नाउ देर इज अ क्लोजर दैट हैपन्स वेन ब्लड फ्लोज इन टू द लेफ्ट एट्रियम, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट क्लोजर यू हैव द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द यू हैव द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ डिप्रेशन, दैट डिप्रेशन इज कॉल्ड एज फोसा ओवैलिस, एंड उसके ऊपर एक जो एलिवेशन है दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द लिम्बस. सो हाउ डज इट लुक इन क्रॉस सेक्शन, ओके, सो यू सी अ डिप्रेस्ड एरिया, यू सी अ डिप्रेस्ड एरिया, एंड इट इज कवर्ड बाय दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ कवरिंग, एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द लिम्बस ऑफ फोसा ओवैलिस. सो दिस इज द डिप्रेशन कॉल्ड एज द फोसा ओवैलिस, एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द लिम्बस ऑफ फोसा ओवैलिस. So the limbus it develops from septum secundum and the fossa ovalis develops from septum prime. Okay, so have you guys understood this, the fight between the right ventricle, right atrium and the left atrium for blood, and through that I have tried to explain the septum formation to you, okay. Is that clear to all of you? Was this explanation creative for you? Did you guys like this way of understanding? Okay, so I've tried to explain through this video the embryology of the heart, where I started with explaining the heart tube and its development, right? And after explaining how the heart tube develops and how the embryology of the heart works, I moved on to this portion, then I talked about teratogenicity and all of this. Okay, so it was a little long lecture. We have discussed everything that I wanted to discuss in this lecture. Okay, so let's recap what all we have learned. Right, now before I recap, I have to ask you guys for a favor. Please hit the like button. Every time you hit the like button, there is some amount of appreciation that I get, and the more likes there are, the more appreciation there is. So please remember to hit the like button. That helps me motivate, that also motivates me to create more such sessions. So do please hit the like button. That does not cost anything from your side, right? And if you guys, so the moment the stream ends, you can also drop a comment, and please share the video to all your first year friends, and if possible, subscribe to our channel, Let's Crack Neet PG. And if at all you plan on subscribing to Unacademy, please always do it with my referral code only, that is either SPCM or Chaitanya10. You can use any of these two referral codes, and for that I also get an incentive at no extra cost to you, okay? So, and in fact you get a discount, and you also get access to all these offers with the referral code, so it's a mutually beneficial thing for both of us. Now for me to revise this for you, like I told you in the start, CVS embryology, it's the most interesting embryology. And at the same time, that is what makes it the most difficult embryology, right? So you have the development of the heart and you have the development of the vessels. That is called as vasculogenesis, right? In that, there are two systems that you have to study about. That is the arterial and the venous. And arterial is relatively more important because there you have to develop a concept of the aortic arches, right? Just like we have studied pharyngeal arches in head and neck, there's a concept of aortic arches. Maybe I'll take it up some other time. But for today, we have discussed the heart, and in heart, there are four concepts, like I told you, in fact, five concepts that you have learned. Okay, first concept that you have learned is the development of the heart tube and which part of the heart tube is going to develop into what. Second concept is cardiac looping, right? And cardiac looping, I just told you that on my Telegram channel, that is @ Unacademy Neet PG Chaitanya, where I'd put the YouTube link for this particular lecture, I'd also put a YouTube link for a 3D animation of the looping of the heart. Okay, I cannot show it to you in this particular live stream because it is copyrighted content. So just go to Unacademy Neet PG Chaitanya, and I've put the link for that YouTube video. It is by a very good illustrator, and you will enjoy it. You will understand cardiac looping through it. Okay, so that is one thing to do. Then next, we studied about three septa: interatrial septa, interventricular septa, and spiral septa. And these three septa are the most important topics in the embryology of the heart. Okay, these are the most important topics. And because of this, there are certain congenital defects that we learned today. What were those? Let's quickly recap. Tetralogy of Fallot, I told you about it. Then I told you about transposition of great arteries. And I told you about truncus arteriosus and the repair for it, that is called as the Rastelli repair. Okay, if you guys have any doubts, you guys can ask me here. Right, I am available for your doubts. And if anything gets left, you can always get in touch with us on our Telegram channel at the rate Let's Crack Neet PG or at the rate Unacademy Neet PG Chaitanya. And in the description, you will find the links for the Telegram channel as well as my Unacademy page. And one more thing, there's a feedback form. So in case you guys like this lecture, please fill that feedback form. But a better thing to do and a very simple thing to do is just hit the like button and drop a comment for me. And I make sure to read all my comments. So there was one mistake also pointed out in one of my videos, and I've taken that. And you guys can also note it that maine screen pe common iliac artery likha hua tha. By mistake, I called it the internal carotid artery. So sometimes those sort of mistakes happen. So I'm really sorry for those mistakes, and I try to make sure that what I write on the screen is mostly correct. Kabhi kabhi bolne mein there's a slip of tongue or something, but whatever I write on the screen, mostly I try to make sure that is correct. And I will also be sending the notes for this entire development on the Telegram channel. If you guys have any other feedback, you guys can let me know about that as well. Okay. Anything you guys want to talk about? Okay, so last question to you guys. Do you guys want to do a few MCQs from this topic? Maybe not today, because today we've already done 1.5 hours. Do you guys want to do some MCQs from the embryology of the heart? Would you guys be interested? Okay, so development of the conducting system. You are asking about how the various parts of the conducting system develop. Okay, very good. So there's a separate development of the valves of the heart. There is a separate development of the pericardial cavity of the heart, and there is a separate development of the conducting system of the heart. Right now, how did the sinoatrial node, SA node, develop? SA node, the two heart tubes, when they fuse, when the two heart tubes, they fuse, the sinoatrial node, it is in the sinus venosus. And when the sinus venosus, it gets merged with the right atrium, it is near the opening of the superior vena cava. So that is where the SA node develops. The AV node and the AV bundle, they are going to develop in the left wall of the sinus venosus. Okay, they are going to develop in the left wall of the sinus venosus. And when the sinus venosus, it is merged. See, do you guys want see what happens? Right, this was the atrium, and this was the sinus venosus. Okay, here right side and here left side, and this is the right atrium. So the AV node, it is present somewhere here. Okay, it is some AV node and the AV bundle, they're present here, right? And when this gets merged, so this is lying towards the left side. So where is the ultimate location of the AV node? In the right atrium towards the left side. In the right atrium towards the left side near the septum. Okay, so that is how the AV node develops. It is present in the wall of the sinus venosus only. There's nothing special to know about the AV node development. Hai na? Uske alawa, if you want, you can read up the development of the pericardial cavity. And a lot of the educators, they might even be teaching about the in fact, you can also read about it in how to do the development of the valves, right? How do the semilunar valves develop, and how do the AV valves develop? Okay, so I'm not covering this into this video, because then this will become very, very long, and that's not required also too much, and you'll be able to understand it. I'd already explained to you about the AV cushions, so that was one thing that is generally difficult to understand. No, so you can read it, and my advice to you is ki embryology, always read from Langmann. And even if you don't read the chapter, at least read the summary. At least read the summary, Langmann says. And obviously, a lot of people, they also refer to I.B. Singh for embryology. So whatever floats your boat, you can refer to it. And ye lectures to hain aapke paas. So any other advices, any other suggestions you have, you guys can drop it in the comments. I'll be ending the stream. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. Last reminder to hit the like button and drop a comment once the video stops streaming. If you subscribe to our channel, Let's Crack an EPG, please do it. And if you want to subscribe to our academy, you can use my referral code Chaitanya10. Hit the bell icon for notifications and join our Telegram channels. Okay, so that you are updated on which educator is going live at which point of time. Okay. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. If you have any doubts, I'm here for another minute. So I hope, Rajaram, that has cleared your doubt about how the AV node develops. You now know how the AV node develops. Okay, and these were some of the offers that we had. So I can, I guess, quickly show you them again. Show them to you again. Right. So we have an offer on the Iconic subscription, where for 3 years you are getting access to both Unacademy and PrepLadder in 58,500. For 1 year, you are getting in 40,000. 2 years, 50,000. 3+1 offer on Plus and 12+2 offer on Plus also. Okay. So yeah, that's about it. Cool. Right. Thank you so much, guys, for watching, and hope you guys take care. Stay safe. Get your families vaccinated. And if you guys have read that there's been a recent paper, paper to kya matlab, there's been a recent study where it has been seen that maybe Covishield is more effective than Covaxin, and I just got Covaxin, so I think I'm less safe, and I don't like that kind of literature where I feel like I've been betrayed. Okay. Anyways. So if you want, you can read that up. And a very good site to be reading papers is PubMed. So just go to PubMed, and whatever you want to read about it, try to read it from a journal. Try to understand how to read journal articles, because it's a skill that is going to help you, because there are decisions that have to be taken that are not there in the textbooks, but they're there in the journals. So journals are a good place to read stuff that you want to read about in detail. Okay. So yeah, that's about it.